Sports. We have the NBA coming up. Great to have you with us. Kevin Harlan here along with analysts Greg Anthony and Steve Smith. And we'll be hearing from DA along the sideline all game long. They'll play this one here in Los Angeles before the Lakers head back to the road. They beat the Warriors during their last encounter in Oakland.
I tell you what, how efficient they were at scoring the basketball, especially for an away game, that was impressive.
They did a good job of controlling the tempo, playing at a speed that suits their offense.
Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, Lonzo Ball knew the Lakers needed a leader, and he thought he could fill that hole. He said a lot of it is natural. I think you're either born a leader or you're not. Now, the Ball family does not shy away from controversy, and it didn't last season either. So none of us know exactly where this is all going to end up. Kevin?
Thanks, David. Steve, how about just getting along? I mean, obviously you want to win and play well, but what about teammates just getting along?
You know, Kevin, I love it because I think there's an expectation if you don't get along, you can't win. There are some teams, you can see these two guys don't like each other, and they still win. But then the teams that is sustained for a long time is the teammates that get along. What you want to do is set, you know, goals that's realistic. And if you can do that and obtain that, then you have a pretty much a good team.
Now Golden State's starting five. And it's all five All-Stars out there for the Warriors. Curry, Klay, Durant, Green, and Cousins.
Showing patience, taking time to read the defense. Draymond finds the open man.
Ball with it, and Curry picks him up defensively. And that one's good, Ingram.
And if he can hit that shot, it spreads the defense out and really changes the complexion of the game.
Opens up opportunities for everyone, makes the offense its most dynamic.
Now here's Curry. He's coming off a 28-point game against the Clippers.
And no one on defense could stay in front of him. He continually got pummeled and kept getting back to the stripe.
Here's Ball, following the basket by Stephen Curry. Ingram outside. That's tipped. Ball against Curry. Buries it down low. And now, just over a minute played here in the first. To the middle. And that's out of bounds. Golden State will retain possession.
Just active defensively here, being extremely disruptive.
You know, I love the effort just to get a hand in there. He is disrupting the offensive flow.
Thompson surveying the floor. Just four to shoot. The Lakers with the rebound. They want to keep rolling here following the win against the Thunder.
And on the road, their perimeter shooting really helped to kind of keep the crowd out of the game.
You know, I was surprised to see how comfortable they were in that environment. Shot a very high percentage from way beyond the arc.
Curry dishes to Thompson. To the middle. Here's Green. Drills the baseline jumper. Green's got his first points in this one.
He's on a team with great mid-range shooters. It's starting to rub off on Draymond Green.
Here's Caldwell Pope. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Several lead changes going on here in the early portion of this game.
It reminds me of that Cameo song, Back and Forth.
Now here's Green. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. From beyond the arc, Tyson Chandler grabs the board. Lakers have gotten their first three shots to go in for him to start off this game. The shot's good from Kuzma.
Yeah, liking the vision there from Caldwell Pope, looking to get his guys going when they're open.
Curry kicks to Thompson. Outside Curry. From deep three-point range, Tyson Chandler pulls it in.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
After four straight makes, couldn't quite get that one to go down. Still a terrific start.
Lakers leading by four. Caldwell poked the bounce pass. Ball against Curry. And Draymond Green picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Down. And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. It's stolen by Green.
I'll tell you what, terrific anticipation defensively. Tracked it all the way. That pass had no chance.
And Thompson gets it to go.
Impressive work from Thompson. Hard for the defense to react on the catch and shoot.
And Draymond Green, an extremely vocal leader. He's in his teammates' ears, always trying to keep them on edge. Also in his opponent's ears as well. And then there's the officials. He tends to like to get in their ears as well.
Yep, that one goes.
We know Steph's skills on the perimeter, but he can work inside with the big guys too.
Looking at the last game for the Golden State Warriors, it was a win against the Clippers in Los Angeles.
Executed on the road, stayed focused, stayed consistent with who you are as a team.
Well, sometimes the away games brings guys together. It's you versus the world in that situation.
Now here's Durant. Brandon Ingram missing his last shot. Durant kicks to Curry. Six on the shot clock. Here's Durant. Chandler with the rebound. Chandler's got 4 rebounds in this game. Hall with a wide open look. A three-pointer, no good. And so it's Durant with it. He'll bring it up for Golden State. No one near Curry as he lets it go. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Green's got 3 assists now in this one. So timeout called here, the first for Los Angeles.
Well, Steph Curry is the face of the Warriors franchise, but you ask around, Draymond Green is the leader in that locker room. He's vocal, plays with an attitude, and his competitive spirit rubs off on the whole team.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, JaVale McGee's checked in for Chandler. Beasley comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Lance Stevenson's checked in for Brandon Ingram. And it's Josh Hart in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Now here's Iguodala. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. Pass to Curry. Here's Looney. He's covered by Ball. Stevenson against Iguodala. From deep. He can't get that one. And the Lakers going the other way now. But Green, really the heart and soul of this Warriors team.
He brings an edge and a toughness that they need. The others are more quiet. He's not afraid to challenge anyone. That's just his nature.
Now, here's Stevenson. Back to Ball. Beasley trying to break free. Ball with the bucket. Ball's got 5 now.
And no doubt, the release point is a bit unorthodox in terms of Ball's shooting technique. But, man, can he slingshot it home from deep.
Curry against Ball. Curry deciding where to go with it. And they come right back with their own three-pointer. He's got 10.
When you combine the usage with the accuracy, hard to think of a better three-point shooter in NBA history. Steph Curry.
And he gets the bucket. Warriors have gone an even 50% from the field. They are 7 of 14 for the game. Now, here's Jerebko, covered by Beasley.
Beautiful play by Sean Livingston. Been able to probe, get inside on the defense, and finish with a slam.
Ball kicks to Stevenson. 59 seconds left in the first quarter. Again, Los Angeles.
And a lot of scoring here early on. This is the type of game the fans love to see.
I love it. Really, both teams running plays that fit the personnel, going back and forth.
Curry can't get it to go. The Lakers trail. 35 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And here's Stevenson. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. Shoots over Livingston. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Look, that's in his range, but he had a defender right up in his chest.
Curry's shot is good.
I mean, Steph's elite scoring ability plus his relentless approach equals greatness.
Ball kicks to Beasley. Here's the teardrop. Got a hand on it. It's been all about Stephen Curry for the Golden State Warriors. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. We'll get right back to the action when we return. So much talent on this Warriors team. Draymond Green talks about how it all meshes together.
The way I judge, you know, whether we can play together or not is on the defensive end. I never really judge on the offensive end. It's about picking each other up on the defensive end and all being on the string.
You know, Greg, defense is Draymond's specialty, no question about it.
And it all starts on that end. The Warriors feel like if they take care of business at that end, the offense will take care of itself.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter in this one. And taking a look at the Warriors' performance here, guys, what are your thoughts?
I mean, really good with their post presence, and it's really allowed them to establish a physical tone here in the first.
Well, you know, in this era, everybody likes the three-point shot. I like their commitment to pounding the ball inside.
Ivica Zubac is out there with JaVale McGee. Then it's Lance Stevenson. Then it's Ball. And it's Hart in at the two spot. That's the group for the Lakers to start the second quarter. Cook kicks to Livingston. Yurevko, the pass to Cook. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Well, finances may be the only thing that can slow down the Warriors. Those star contracts placed them way above the salary cap. Big luxury taxes are on the horizon.
Iguodala outside. Looney passes to Cook. Off target with his three. Lakers trail by four. Inside, here's Stevenson. Lays it up off the glass. Stevenson's got four this quarter.
And that's what the pump fake's there for. Get your man off his feet and drive right around him.
Now, here's Jurebko. He's covered closely. Iguodala kicks to Jurebko. That falls. Nice feed that time from Andre Iguodala. And the Warriors lead by five.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Now, here's Ball. He's tightly guarded. Here's McGee. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And a moment now to see some numbers for Iguodala. He's putting up about 5 points a game, three rebounds, and three assists. And the numbers won't wow you, but I like the effort he brings to the table each and every night.
You need guys who understand their roles. Carry them out without complaint. Everything he does is for the team.
First one falls for him. Steve, more and more we hear about players wanting to be traded. The information comes out publicly, whether they leak it or their agent leaks it. Is this a new development, in your opinion?
Yeah, I think because of social media, Kevin, right now, everybody hears a little bit, and even if it's true or not true, it gets spread like wildfire, and it can reach so many different people because of social media quickly, and I think that's the problem we're having right now. It's, you know, social media can be a plus, but it also can be a negative.
That's a good observation. Now, here's Green, outside Durant, from downtown. It's hauled in by Zubac. Lakers trail by three. Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Kyle Kuzma had a tough upbringing in Flint, Michigan. He said they had the recession, lead in the water. It was like an urban war zone. We probably moved 14 times before I was 16. Basketball was my key. And his drive to succeed in the NBA was born of a desire to escape that environment. Kevin?
A tremendous work ethic, David. Thank you. Here is Cook after Los Angeles picked up three with their last shot. Trills the three-pointer.
And that's where KD just feasts with this team. When it comes to those spot-ups, he's as good as anyone in the league.
Here's Ingram. And the rebound goes to the Warriors.
He got a good look from the mid-range area. He needs to shoot this one with more confidence.
Durant kicks to Green. And it's Golden State with another.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Now here's Ingram. Steady offensive output from him, averaging more than 16 points a game. Here's Hart over Thompson. Hart, no good. on the wing, Thompson, guarded by Kuzma. To the inside. Here's Durant. There's JaVale McGee with the rebound. Lakers trail by five. Ball's knocked loose, stolen by Thompson. Stolen by Zubats. It's good.
No one rotating over to help on the mismatch. Easy lay-in.
Here is Cook. At the elbow, it's Cousins. McGee with the block. But they get it back. Now, here's Kuzma. Tries again. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
Clearly a foul.
Lakers shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night.
Shooting two.
Free throw good, Kuzma. And Los Angeles with some changes. Tyson Chandler is checked in for JaVale McGee. Beasley comes in for Ivica Zubats. And it's Caldwell Pope in for Hart. And the Warriors also making a change. Steph Curry's checked in for Cook. He's perfect from the line this time. And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for Golden State. Pass to Green. Now the dish to Durant. Excellent D there from Beasley.
And forcing the miss there. He just knows how to pressure you defensively.
And also protecting the rim at all costs. I love the anticipation to affect the shot.
And Caldwell Pope, the Georgia product, when he's on the floor, it's for his defense. Can give you a handful of points, but what he takes away with defense is far more significant. One of the better perimeter defenders since entering the league.
And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Caldwell Pope. This gives us the chance to view the best three-point shooting teams this season. The real stats, the real scores from the real NBA. Second, the Warriors.
No doubt, they have snipers on that roster, that's for sure. It's been a terrific year for them from beyond the arc.
Cousins finds Durant. Back to Cousins. Tyson Chandler pulls it in. Chandler's got five rebounds tonight. And with Caldwell Pope and his defense, he can guard any type of perimeter play.
Yeah, I mean, he has the long arms to bother small forwards and fast feet to stay with point guards. Really gives the lineup a lot of options in terms of matchups when he's on the floor. Great instincts on defense, and it's very hard to shake as he'll hound you through screen.
To end the cold streak, shot is good off the back rim and in. Thompson's got five.
Thompson is lightning quick in the open floor. Terrific at running the court from end to end.
Ingram passes to Kuzma. Shot on the wing. A shot that time, not on target. The Warriors go the other way with it. And stolen by Kuzma. And in transition, it's Ingram. Here we go. Los Angeles with another miss. Golden State's gone to the three-pointer 11 times tonight, nailed five of them. Here's Curry, and no good, trying to use the glass.
Unfortunately for him, the defense is slow to react, but he couldn't make them pay.
Kuzma kicks to Caldwell Pope. Shot clock at six. It's stolen by Green. Thompson dishes to Curry. There's 14 seconds left now here in the second. Five to shoot. From deep three-point range. And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. The Warriors on top, up by one. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Draymond, of course, not unusual to see you going up against bigger players. So how do you take advantage of that offensively?
I mean, you just got to take advantage of mismatches. You know, most of the time there's a big guy on me. If not, there's usually somebody trying to switch off. You know, I just got to know when to pop and just take advantage of the mismatches.
You've done just that in the first half. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks. Welcome back. This is Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal at 2K Sports. Let's talk first half. Golden State found themselves in a close game in the first. At the end of the period, they held a four-point lead. They were outscored by just a bit in the second quarter as they go into the break now holding just a one-point advantage. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
I love the motion on offense. Guys are moving, the ball is moving. It's a very nice approach to the game and one the defense absolutely could not keep up with.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Lakers?
Well, their reserves came in and played like starters, gave them some big points off the bench. It'll be no surprise to see them get more minutes in the second half. They definitely deserve it. Though sometimes when you get more minutes, you get exposed. We shall see.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during the half. Curry with a strong contribution so far in this one.
And I love the game plan in that first half. They really valued each possession.
You know what? It's hard to do. Staying focused and disciplined with your approach.
And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. While we've got a moment, let's set the floor. Brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up for the second half. And Golden State looking at who they've got. Thompson and Durant fill out the perimeter. Down low, it's Green and Cousins. And it's Curry in at the point guard position. Some smaller players spend most of their time on the perimeter. Others really sacrifice, Steve, their bodies to make plays inside.
I think some of the small guys that get in there, like you said, is Kyrie Irving, one of the best at finishing. Kemba Walker, Mike Conley, Isaiah Thomas, Steph Curry. Some of these smaller guys who don't mind throwing their body into the paint.
And at 6'6", Ball, very similar to Jason Kidd in terms of the vision that he plays the game with. His IQ is off the charts.
Good on the second free throw.
He wanted to get his team the lead, and even though he didn't, he should feel good. At least he tied it up.
Thompson outside. Now the pass to Green. Kicks it to Curry. He's looking for Cousins and finds him. Outside Durant. There's the triple. Good. And it's Cousins picking up the assist. And it's 8 points for Kevin Durant.
As we've seen, some guys develop range as the years go on. Not Durant. He shot over 42% from three in his second season.
And that one's good. Ingram. And here's Curry, who brings it up for the Golden State Warriors. It's a one-point game. To the middle. Here's Thompson. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Thompson's got 7.
Aggressive into the teeth of the defense. Klay showing he's not just a threat on the perimeter.
Kuzma inside. Guarded by Green. And it's Ball in the corner. 6 on the shot clock. On its way from Caldwell Pope for 2. Thompson with the rebound. Warriors leading by 3. Inside, Green. He's off on that one. Some solid defense from Ingram. Ball against Curry. Fires from 18. And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Not sure of the thought process on that one. Really bad shot selection.
Well, you're playing for the team, not just yourself. They needed much better execution that trip down the floor.
Caldwell Pope outside. Ball with it. 6 points for him. Pass to Ingram. And he uses the glass on the layup. Ingram's got 4 points this quarter.
And the speed of Ingram makes him a nightmare for defenses in pick and rolls, constantly keeping them guessing.
To the inside. The shot by Thompson, no good.
You know what? He tried to lay it in at the point of attack. Just too much defensive pressure on that play.
Now Ball. He gives the team some steady offense, a bit under 10 points a game. It's going to be out of bounds. Los Angeles will retain possession. Let's check out the Western Conference standings right now that we're here in the new year. You look at Golden State, and not a surprise really to see them sitting there in that number one spot in the conference. The excellent brand of basketball they've been putting on display lately has been terrific. And, of course, the Lakers, 7 games back.
And seeing where the Warriors are, they've had just the kind of season you knew they were capable of. I mean, they've got all the talent in the world, but how about maximizing it to the fullest?
That's been the key. This coaching staff knows what their strengths are. They play to those strengths. That's how they've gotten the most out of their talent.
A big group substitution here for the Lakers. JaVale McGee's checked in for Chandler. Ivica Zubac has checked in for Kyle Kuzma. Lance Stevenson's checked in for Ingram. And it's Josh Hart in for Caldwell Pope. Your Rebco's checked in for the Warriors. Quinn Cook comes in for Steph Curry. The Lakers have hit most of their free throws tonight, 5 of 6. Tied up with that one. Third quarter here, and 3 minutes have come off the clock. Cook, the pass to Yurepko. He dishes it to Durant. Good work there as it goes. Durant's got 7 now in this quarter.
And they've had assists now in their last 3 baskets.
Kevin Durant last season becoming the second youngest player in NBA history to score 20,000 career points, trailing only LeBron James. That's elite company.
Now, here's Stevenson. 8 points for him. Just 3 to shoot over Yurepko, and the Lakers tack on 2 more. Just over 3.5 minutes through the third quarter of play now. Cook kicks to Thompson. Golden State moving it around. Here is Cook. He's covered by Ball, and it's Cook missing. And you think KD has an outside chance to set the all-time scoring record?
I do. I wouldn't put it past him. Height and shooting touch are two things that you don't lose with age.
Pass to Cook. He kicks to Thompson. In the corner, Cook with it. Just 5 to shoot. Golden State needs to get off a shot. And the Warriors get it back. Here's Cousins. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Why does the pump fake work? Because of DeMarcus Cousins' ability to score at all 3 levels. The defender knows he has to close hard to have a chance.
The Warriors shooting their first free throws of the game.
Gentlemen, 2 shots. Loose shots.
The first free throw is good. Steve, you had an excellent playing career. Talk a little bit about the work you had to put in and just to get to the NBA.
Yeah, it comes down to that work ethic. Obviously, we all have talent, but you have to put in that work. And that work continues on the court, off the court, and it's basically 365 days a year. where you had to find a way to get better.
Was it mainly shooting for you?
No, not mainly shooting for me, Kevin. I think it was always just my overall game.
Now, here's Stevenson. 10 points for him.
I love the technique he uses, leveraging his position down low, then just using sheer size to snatch the rebound. I love how he's been more patient in this second half, shooting only the shots he feels he can make.
And here's Ball. Kevin Durant picking up that last basket. Unloads from 13. Tries again. That's good, and the Warrior lead is cut down now to just two on the basket from McGee.
And that solid play in the paint continues here, guys.
Iguodala outside. Let's it go from 14. That one wide left.
And that's the look this offense is designed to produce.
Always frustrating when you do everything right, yet just can't complete the play.
Now, here's Ball. 6 points for him. Passes to Hart. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. Let's it go from 11. Zubac, no good. Golden State's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Iguodala finds Livingston. Here's Cousins. And then Cousins with the dunk.
Sean Livingston's court vision is amazing. Being able to hit the open guy right on stride.
Lakers trail by four. Timeout called, the Lakers. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
Michael Beasley, he's checked in for Zubac. Durant, that's good.
Yeah, what a quarter for him. Firing on all cylinders, putting this team in a good place.
Here's McGee, and the refs are going to rule that unnecessary contact. It's a flagrant one foul.
And, Kevin, that's a pretty dangerous play right there. I mean, I don't like to see a player put an opponent in harm's way, as much as you just saw him do there. Glad they pinned a flagrant on.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. The officials were all over it. They weren't going to let him off the hook that time. First free throw is good. Steve, you think about Coach Steve Kerr as a player, the 50th pick in 1988, and for his career, the best three-point percentage in NBA history.
I played with him, and I played against him. Always had to know where he was on the floor. The perfect coach for this sharp-shooting team.
The Warriors making a switch here. Green's checked in. Now, here's Stevenson. He's guarded closely. Ball dishes to Stevenson. Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession. A chance to check out Los Angeles' upcoming schedule. On Saturday, they'll be matching up with Chris Paul and the Houston Rockets. Then on Monday, they'll take on Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors.
And for that game against the Timberwolves, I think it's going to be an interesting challenge. Even though they expect to come out on top, this could probably be a pick'em game, depending on how they play.
It's Durant on the wing. He's guarded by Stevenson. Green, no luck. Lakers trail by five. Feeds it to Stevenson. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball. And 12 points for Lance Stevenson.
And not being as aggressive from the three-point line anymore. They had a lot more attempts in that first half.
Here's Livingston, and good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim.
Everybody talks about the three ball, but Sean Livingston understands his game. The mid-range game, he's a master at it.
Ball kicks to Beasley. Charity stripe shot. Off on that one. And so it's Kevin Durant making headlines and highlights for the Golden State Warriors. He comes away with 11 points in the quarter and is showing no signs of fatigue. Back right after this. And let's take this chance now to show you the State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
Execution. This is what you practice every day. These guys are professionals. Beautiful play.
We've reached the fourth quarter, and what has been a very competitive game should be an exciting finish. They've got Kyle Kuzma. Hart is out there with Ingram. And it's Chandler, and it's Beasley in at the four slot. That's who's in the game for the Lakers.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Iguodala against Ingram. Doesn't get it to drop for him. Warriors leading by 7. Here's Green, and 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. That one is on Beasley.
Known for defense and rebounding coming out of college, Draymond Green has surprised some scouts with his early production on the offensive end.
The first free throw is good. Well, Iguodala signing an extension with the Warriors in the summer of 2017. He did not come cheap. 3 years and $48 million.
Well, I guess he sacrificed enough. He comes off the bench. They ask him to guard everybody. He earned that payday.
And the Lakers making a change here. Caldwell Pope's checked in. Lakers trail by 9. Here's Hart. The pass to Kuzma. And the 3 ball is good.
You can see there, the defender allows himself to get picked.
You know, it's all about effort. Sometimes you're going to get hit on hard screens. You just have to fight through them.
Now here's Iguodala. Six to shoot. He feeds it to Green. And there's the whistle. 3-second violation. And some changes here for the Warriors. Nurebko comes in for Looney. And it's Thompson in for Sean Livingston. LA has gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly. Hart the pass to Caldwell Pope. For 3, and the rebound goes to the Warriors. Green's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight, and Thompson gets it to go.
Nice work from Thompson, very confident, rising up whenever he gets a chance at a pull-up J.
Hart kicks to Caldwell Pope. Here's Hart. Back to Caldwell Pope. Shoots over Curry. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Kyle Kuzma. That's his first foul. Warriors leading by 9. Curry kicks to Thompson. Ball stolen.
And really, he played mistake-free basketball up to that point. That's the only time he's turned it over so far.
Back to Chandler. Lakers working the ball around now. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Hart, guarded by Kirk. Hart, that's good.
If the defense is going to keep giving him those shots, you know he has the confidence to knock them down.
Pass to Thompson. Stolen by Caldwell Pope. Here's Ingram. Warriors with the rebound. Their biggest lead of the game was 9.
And tonight, he just hasn't been efficient offensively. That's a big reason why they're behind.
Kuzma kicks to Ingram, and slam dunk by Ingram.
And at 6'9", Ingram is constantly on the prowl for these dunks. An incredible athlete who just finishes with ease near the hoop.
Now, here's Curry. And here is Iguodala outside Curry. 5 on the clock for 3. No good on that one. And the Lakers going the other way now. They can look forward to the Rockets Arena after this matchup to take on Houston. That'll be just one game played away from home for them. Kuzma passes to Hart. That's good, and the Warrior lead is cut down now to just 2 points with that basket from Ingram.
Really smoking the Nets now after a difficult time shooting in the first half.
Timeout called the Warriors.
Yeah, you need to refocus now. Momentum is running against you.
And from what I'm seeing, is too many unfavorable matchups out there on the floor.
The Lakers making a switch here. Ball's checked in. And the Warriors also making a change. Cousins is checked in. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Well, Steve Kerr talked to his team during the last timeout, and he's pushing them to empty the tank. He said, I know you're tired and it's been a tough game, but we can't hold back. If you're tired, come out. Otherwise, I want you full speed, guys.
And so Curry will bring it up for Golden State. Thompson outside. Green finds Curry on deep. The Lakers with the rebound. Ingram's got his fourth rebound in this one. Kuzma against Green. Back to Ball. Pass to Kuzma. To take the lead. Out to Ingram. Passes it to Hart. And at last, they get one to fall. And the Lakers lead by two. Curry passes to Thompson. And the Warriors miss again. And here's Los Angeles. They're on a 14-3 run. And the pass to Chandler. Ball against Curry. Down low, Ingram. And slam dunk by Ingram.
And after playing 1 year at Duke, Ingram is used to providing big baskets for his club. Just dominating with ease in these moments.
Timeout called the Warriors. And now let's present our Jordan Player of the Game, Kyle Kuzma.
And he's provided them with a major mismatch on that low block tonight. That they've been able to lean on his scoring in the paint. And if nothing else has worked, he's given them a reliable option on every possession.
Kevin Durant's checked in for Golden State. And so here is Golden State, trailing by four. Thompson for the triple. And again, no good by Golden State. Los Angeles has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Got it. Good job in the low post.
This is why you like to get him touches. He makes things happen.
Warriors trail by six. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
That's what he does. Put the ball in KD's hands, and he'll deliver.
Here's Hart. We've got 1:48 left to play here in the fourth. Knocked away. Thompson outside. Durant in the corner. No good with the wing jumper. And here's Los Angeles. They're on an 18-5 run here. Hart, no good.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time. You can just see the passion and love with which he plays the game. You see how he prepares, the work ethic, the way he interacts with his teammates. And when he hits the floor, it's all about the game.
Now, here's Kuzma. Six to shoot. It's stolen by Green. To take the lead. It's good!
What more can you ask for?
Phenomenal here in the clutch. This is what fans tune in to see.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're trailing by one. There's 53 seconds left to play here in the fourth. The There's 53 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Kuzma. Ball kicks to Hart. Clock at six. Pass to Kuzma. Ingram with it. From past the arc. No good that time. Curry against Ball. Now here's Curry. Defense is right there. Passes to Durant. Over Ingram. And it's Durant missing. Los Angeles calls timeout. They trail by one. 6 seconds left in the game. What do you think, guys?
You know what? Enough time that they can run whatever play they're most comfortable with.
Patience is the key. Let's see what they come up with here.
Six seconds left in the fourth. The Trey can't knock in the three. And an intentional foul right there. And so Steve Kerr decides to call a timeout. So it's a narrow victory for the Warriors, pulling out the W. They break the hearts of every fan in the building with a dramatic late victory.
And Kevin, this is the kind of win you have to take a ton of pride in. I mean, they battled with everything they had and came through when the pressure was at its highest.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, not the prettiest of wins, but you got it. What got it for you?
Well, we just wanted to keep plugging away, keep moving the basketball. We got good shots in the first half. They didn't fall, but we just stayed confident and, you know, stayed aggressive. So, you know, it was one of those games that you got to grind out, and that's what we did.
That's how you build a great record through the season. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.